morning, friends, and happy new day, happy new week. And my prayer for you, even as the lockdown is all over, that you begin to break forth in the name of Jesus. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name for a brand new day like this, a day you have made for our joy, for us to rejoice therein. We pray this week that in order our steps, honor your word in our life. Let things ease for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Beloved brethren, I'm starting another series today, and the theme is divine remembrance. Divine remembrance. And I pray for someone listening to me, in the name of Jesus Christ, where it matters most, you'll be remembered in Jesus' name. Now you see, many lives have been waiting, and many are in bondage, many are trapped. But just one right thought, one right remembrance changes everything. And I'm going to start this day talking about the story as recorded in Malachi chapter 3. Malachi chapter 3, 15 and 16. The Bible says, and which is something that is always happening, it says, some people started complaining, what is the benefit of serving God? We are serving God, we are not seeing results. Then the scripture says, then they came together, those that are serving God, and they speak with one another. They communicate, they fellowship, and a book of remembrance was opened. Beloved brethren, I pray for you in this season as we fellowship together. Thank God that the government is even returning to opening of churches. As we begin to fellowship together with you and your colleague and your family, with your spouse, with your children, as a fellowship together, may the right prayer point be raised, and may God open a book of remembrance for Samuel. So as the people fellowship together, as they speak with one another, a book of remembrance was opened. Somebody will suddenly remember you. Mm-hmm. If there was nobody that remembered Joseph, he won't have the opportunity to speak in the palace. If nobody remembered to talk about John the Baptist, to the ears of Jesus, I wonder how John the Baptist's work would have been fulfilled. So I'm praying for you. In the name of Jesus, will be remembered. In Genesis chapter 21, a woman have waited for 25 years. And in Genesis chapter 18, God spoke. In Genesis chapter 21, I love you to read that scripture. The Bible says in verse 1 and 2, say, Sarah was remembered, and God did unto Sarah as he has said. He did unto Sarah as he has spoken, and Sarah brought forth a son. In verse 6 and 7, Sarah has said, say, who would have imagined it? Who would have believed it? I don't know what people are not believing about your situation. I don't know how you have given up on yourself. I don't know how people have given up on you, but I have a good news for you. This week, God will open a remembrance concerning you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I conclude. In Isaiah 56, the Bible says God was speaking. He said, my word will not return to me void. It shall perform the purpose. The purpose of God speaking this word to you this morning shall be fulfilled. God will remember you. In the way he remembered Noah and stopped the flood, he will remember you in the name of Jesus. I pray for you this morning. Father, let mercy locate everyone listening to me. Let mercy speak on behalf of everyone listening to me. Whatever sin that must be forgiven, let it be forgiven. Whatever must be blotted, let the blood of Jesus blot it out. Lord, let us be remembered for good in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' name we pray. I'll see you tomorrow. God Almighty will remember you for good. Amen. God bless you.